All right, so here's my property, and Addie's property, and Kyle's property, and Ralph's property, and
Gnarly.
And Gnarly Vollmer's property. Gnarly Vollmer is the cat's name. I can't even remember it half the time.
Gnarls Vollmer Darwin.
Gnarls Vollmer Darwin is the cat. SS Art, that's the cat's name, SS Art. Even I can't remember it half the time. So.
Gnarls Darwin, okay? Because he's gnarly.
Well, SS Art and I have trouble remembering it. So, anyways, what we're doing today is going back onto my neighbor's property, which is that farm you see directly in front of us.
Ponies!
And he's got two horses off to the left. He has some trees that were taken down behind his house, where you see the big silo there. And behind that silo is two...
Ditch.
I know, I see it. There's two several large trees. From what I saw was two trees, but he said there are several large trees there that were taken down in December. And he said that, sorry, not that silo. There's actually another one over here, I think. And on the right.
There's like a house in those trees too. Or something.
Yeah. So there's a big pile of trees over here that was taken down in December. And he wants those moved soon because they're kind of a fire hazard for the helm. So we're coming over here today to collect those.
I see something shiny.
Yep, there's the cattle feed silo, I think is what he called this.
Oh, I guess it looks like an ice cream shop for cows.
I thought it was a hunting shack when I was looking at it from up on the right, up in the woods over there. But
it does look like an ice cream shack for cows. I see no trees.
You were going to have to walk to it. We go over to the feeder thing, and then we see it's right behind it.
Trees.
And there's a big tire over there, too. So we just gotta be a little careful how we get over there. I've never driven this section of the field before.
I like horses.
We are now on the neighbor's property, so obviously I've never driven on his field.
Oh, maybe that's sideways. Maybe that's not how it's supposed to start. No, it's supposed to be that way. Boy, that is weird.
I think it's sideways.
It's got taillights.
It's sideways because the taillights are all wrong. Rolled over.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, see the trails right over there. The trees right over there. So we just got to climb and find the best way to get over there. I think I'm going to pull in and try to back up to where that tire is there.
You might want to loop around to the outside because this looks moist in here. Ah, there's a burdock on the...
Not anymore.
Oh, it's still there. Those
things. Icky. He said cherry, right? Yeah, he said he thought they were cherry.
They look like oak and cherry.
Yeah. This wood, we gotta chop up one, take what we can. So this is where we're focused for the next couple of days.
Oh, it's so shiny.
All right, where's that tire?
It even says real on it. The tire is over to the left of about 20 feet, I think. Nope, 5 feet. Moved on. Found the tire.
Can you open your door?
Yeah.
Okay. Alrighty.
Oh, ha! You didn't want me to open the door. You just wanted to know if I could.
Yeah, I just wanted to know if you could.
Yes, I can.
Alright, this looks like a good spot. We got a big branch on the side of the truck. So, I just talked to him, and so he knows we're back here now, and he's getting ready to leave here shortly, but he told his niece, I think it's his niece, relative, whatever, that we're going to be here.
So, not to be too freaked out.
Go ahead and make sure all the windows are rolled up. Let's go look at the wood we're getting. Do not lock your door. Alrighty.
Wow, this is a trick.
So, we'll break out the chainsaw. Chop. There's some big cherry there. I think that's cherry with the prickly bark. Alrighty, let's get to work. Alright, so we got a whole lot of it cut. Not all of it, but a lot of it. So there's a bunch of logs left there that we can't load into the truck right now. And some scraps here, some logs there that we can't. We got a full load. You can tell by the tires, kind of bulging out now. This is this looks small, you know, but it is extremely heavy. It's what, an oak?
I think so, yeah.
I think it's an oak. And it's a green oak too, so if you've ever held a green oak, you know it's really freaking heavy.
Green as in not dry, not like a type of,
yeah.
Age-wise.
Yeah, green as in it's
soaking wet,
full of water, still partially alive, and budding. And some of the branches were, but so this is a, even though it looks like a small load, it's a very dense and very heavy load. Yeah, so this is definitely at least a week's worth of firewood right here. Maybe even 2 weeks because it's so hard. It's a very hard wood. So, alrighty, we're gonna get this in, unload it, and for chopping wood today, this will be all the wood that we chop for today. And then the rest of the day, we're gonna work on getting some. We got one wind turbine anchor in the ground yesterday, right?
You did, yeah.
Yeah, yesterday. So I'm going to, after we unload the truck and rest a little bit, then I'm going to try to get a second anchor in. And hopefully we can get all the anchors in today and tomorrow and get the wind turbine back up. But we'll do, my goal is to do a truckload a day, 1 to 2 truckloads a day of wood. So we got our truckload for today, and so I'm happy. And we'll go stack this up. All right, so this is a look at our wood stack. That's the one load, the first load that we had got several days ago. And then this is the second load that we had got about halfway up. And then the from the mid section up is what I just stacked on it just now and raised it up. Can't really go up much higher until I put something in the ground here to keep it from rolling off. So, got to put a few more logs in to bring it up to the tree here.
That's kind of a temporary pile too.
Yeah. And then, come around over here. Camera battery's dead, so don't know how long this is going to last. This is actually two rows of logs, so this is what I was stacking while Addie was stacking over here.
I try to stack stuff on the ground, yeah. So I'm bending it.
Yeah, so.
And I'm trying to put logs on here that go from the long run to the long run, so I don't know how long these slats would put up with weight just in the middle.
Yeah.
So we'll see.
So, clarify. That 2x4 right there in the center to this 2x4, she's trying to put logs to span the width of it so that it'll hold the weight better than those little 1x4s. So this is all our wood right now that we've been collecting. Of course, the wood tent here is full of wood too. I'll take you in there real quick so you can see all the wood that we have in there. That there's the wood that we have split to go into the cabin tonight. And can you hold this open? So here is, that's the bark that we use for kindling. And, I almost dropped the camera. That we use for kindling and for keeping this going. But just real quick, this is all our split wood here. So that's about 2 weeks worth of split wood there. Some more seasoned wood there. And then all that wood. So, as you can see, we've got already this right wood right here is what will get us through the next few weeks for the cold that's still about. And the wood that you see there is a couple months worth of wood there and there. That'll get us through next winter. And you know, that's the goal here, is to collect enough wood right now and this spring to get us through next winter so we don't have to worry about it. If this spring we can connect enough wood to get us through the next two winters, then by next winter it'll all be seasoned. And all we have to do is split it up like this and like that and what you saw in there. So once we get all these billets cut.
I'm hoping to split it too, yeah. Before winter.
Well, I'm hoping to get all the billets cut by the end of spring.
Okay.
And then we could split it through summer, but I want to get all the billets cut and stacked before spring is over. To have enough billets cut to get us through next winter and the winter after that. And then once that's done, then we'll worry about splitting it, and we'll split that as we go through summer. We'll take it and split it and restack it.
My goal, I'm gonna be on Hoarders, or one of those shows about people that hoard, because I'm gonna have so much wood, I won't have to worry.